out. So there's where my toys went,
thought Jeremy grimly.
They went to that town instead of my chimney.
And his anger grew stronger as he watched a boy trot full of pride side by side with a brand new robot, which Jeremy had asked for and wanted a lot. And the longer he watched, the more angry he got.
Have you something to say, little girl?
If I can.
Then speak in the mic. Face the cameraman.
I want to thank Santa.
The girl cleared her throat.
You must have dropped Santa a very long note.
Well, all I can say is none of us wrote.
That's just amazing, because if it's true, some kid did something real special for you.
Whoever you are, whoever did write, we'd like to say thank you with all of our might.
Jeremy heard the words and just froze, blushing with guilt.
What was with the running? If you can call that running.
I was giving you time to catch up.
Aw, you big lug.
To his toes.
Special?
He couldn't believe what she'd said.
My greed has been taken for kindness instead.
Now everyone, everywhere, thought some nice kid had tried to help others, though he never did. No one had guessed the note was sent by a meanie who planned to grab everything, king size and teeny. And he watched as the thousands of kids on TV waved their toys in the air for the whole world to see. And he thought,
did I ask for all of that just for me? How mean and greedy can one kid be? Goodbye!
Thousands of girls and thousands of boys are spending this Christmas with lots of new toys because some nice youngster who knew they were missed wrote to old Santa and sent him a list. Crayoned on paper that stretched half a mile, writing this list must have taken a while.
What a nice thing to do,
said Jeremy's mother.
It's kind when a person does things for another.
Strange. Didn't say who he was on the letter.
Good people don't boast who they are. They know better.
Jeremy Creek, face flushed with pride, suddenly felt tears well up inside. Tears that the little boy wanted to hide. So he ran from the den till his misty eyes dried. He dropped on the floor, crawled under the tree, and hid in the glow where the gifts ought to be, knowing that somehow he had done a good thing, made him feel light as a bright angel's wing. It was kindness, he felt. A change had begun. His greedy core melted like frost in the sun. He felt happy and warm, crouched there on the floor.
Gee, I wish I'd learned to be nice long before.
He gazed at the sights of the tinsel-decked tree. Through the twinkling lights, he thought he could see a small, jolly Santa, the size of an egg, sitting above him, swinging one leg. Santa said,
Hi, I've made myself small and flown down to tell you I know about all. How you were greedy, why you were missed, and how the needy got the toys on your list. Now the Swamp Town kids thank you and ask me to bring their hero and friend some magical thing. So, what would you like on this fair Christmas day?
Gee, I really can't say. What I thought that I wanted was given away. And after what's happened, I've come to believe it's more fun to give than it is to receive.
Then this is my gift. Beginning today, you'll be my assistant aboard the great sleigh. You're just the right boy to help give toys away.